I looked through each Pokemon move to see what the best one of each base power is. We know that higher base power generally means the move will be more useful, but why not show some love to moves at a lower base power too? For this ranking, we'll look at how useful the move is competitively, while considering in-game use to an extent. Characteristics like accuracy, typing, secondary effects, and distribution will be considered, although signature moves are fair game. I will be including the moves at their listed base powers, so a move like Acrobatics that doubles in power without an item will still be considered 55 base power. I will also include two options when I choose a multi-strike move, since they are generally lower base power, and that's kind of unfair to their single-strike counterparts. I want to hear your opinions on what the best moves for the different base powers are, so make sure to leave a comment. Let's see the first move. Starting from the lowest base power moves, we have the 10 base power triple kick. This is a multi-strike move, and I know I just said I'd give two options when I choose one, but there's no way I'm including the move Constrict on a best moves list. That's the only other move with base 10 power. Triple kick hits at 10 base power, then 20 on the second hit, and 30 on the third, making it not the worst move in the world, but definitely not great. Onto 15 base power, we pretty much have only multi-strike moves to choose from. In fact, a lot of this initial list will be filled with them. The best at this base power though is Water Shuriken, having better accuracy than most, being special, which is cool, and having priority on a decent offensive typing to boot. We'll include Poison Sting as the second option, since it's the only other 15 base power attack that isn't multi-strike. Super weak, but at least a 30% poison chance is good early game. Moving on to an interesting 18 base power, we have just two options: Fury Swipes and Comet Punch. These moves are very similar. There are a lot more users for Fury Swipes, but Comet Punch is objectively just a better move. It has slightly better accuracy and gets boosted by Iron Fist, which most users have. Here's a quick buff for Fury Swipes though, have it be boosted by the ability Sharpness, and still watch it be trash. We jump up to the impressive 20 base power moves. I'm not even kidding though, we are starting to see some very competitively great moves now. We have some amazing moves here. Stored Power and Power Trip are situational, but can be great at sweeping, and Triple Axle is just an amazing version of Triple Kick, with its hits being twice the base power each. But I'm going to say the best move is Mosehold's Population Bomb. Being able to hit up to 10 times is just bonkers. It lacks super effective hits, but still gets the job done on a Mon whose stats leave a lot to be desired. For non-multi-hit moves, I'm going to give it to Nuzzle, which has a guaranteed paralysis chance while doing a bit of damage. It's mostly given to weaker most Pokemon, but distribution has slowly been widening on this great move. At 25 base power, we exclusively see multi-strike moves. While almost all of these are good, notably Icicle Spear and Scale Shot, the number one spot easily goes to Surging Strikes. It guarantees 3 hits, and they all result in a critical hit. So this guy is kind of cheating the other 25 base power moves out of a spot, but I couldn't put anything else here. 30 base power is a little weaker of a move class, but we had a really great move recently introduced in Glamora's Mortal Spin. It poisons opposing Pokemon while doing damage and removing entry hazards. One of the best support attacks, especially considering Glamora has corrosion, meaning you can poison anything with it. 35 base power has a bunch of trapping moves, and Peck, don't forget Peck. Double Hit is a solid choice on Technician Ambipom too, but not worthy of top spot. This is a crapshoot, but I think I'm gonna go with Whirlpool as it has the most viable users. Tapu Fini can use it to set up, Parish Song, Azumarill, and Dugong are very real users. I even used to use Whirlpool on Cursola combined with Curse to beat annoying bulky mons. I just see more use for it over the other trapping moves at this base power, although they are basically the same. Moving on to 40 base power, we start to see beginning moves, basic priority moves, and other solid options. There are actually so many competitively useful moves here. I want to at least mention Fake Out, as it's such an important move, especially in doubles, but the best one has to go to Garganacle's Salt Cure. The passive damage that goes until the target switches out is too good. You hate to face this move in any format, especially if you have water and steel types that take a crazy 25% of their max HP per turn. At 45 base power, we see but one move: the courageous Fine Whip, who decided 35 base power wasn't good enough for it in Generation 6, being buffed 10 base power. This foresight landed at a spot in my video as the unanimous winner. At 50 base power, we have some powerhouse moves. It's a shame Rapid Spin is only an honorable mention here, since it's such an important move. But we have two strong ghost type moves that are way too good to pass up. The runner up is Annihilate's Rage Fist. It starts at 50 base power and gets powered up 50 more every time this Pokemon takes a hit. The move better than this though, I have Last Respects, which is a similar concept to Rage Fist, but you don't even need the user to take any hits to power it up. It just gets more powerful the more fainted teammates you have. The move had Houndstone and Basculegion banned to Ubers, with whole team styles dedicated to setting up the Last Respects Mega Sweep endgame. We settle down a bit as we bump up to 55 base power. These are mostly moves that do okay damage while lowering a stat. It came down to two moves, the runner-up being Snarl. It lowers all opponent's special attack by one Sage while doing damage. But the best 55 base power move goes to Icy Wind. This is an ice type version of Snarl that lowers their opponent's speed stat rather than special attack. This is usually more useful as speed control is very important in doubles, while lowering special attack is a lot more situational. You rarely see either of these moves in singles anyways, so if I had to give it a choice just for singles, it would be Acrobatics, which is used on certain Pokemon who consume their item to power up this move. As we get to the last moves that are boosted by Technician, we have potentially some of the best moves in the game to choose from. Flip Turn is a great pivot move recently added. We also have Barb Barrage, having a 50% poison chance and doubling to 120 base power if the target is poisoned. There are a few other really strong moves. The best move, no doubt, goes to Melmetal's Double Iron Bash. This move's 60 base power is really 144 after considering it hits twice and is boosted by Iron Fist, but on paper, it fits here. The crazy flinch chance is the icing on the cake here, putting it far and above any other 60 base power move. Since it is a multi-strike move though, I will include another choice. Arguably the best priority move in the game besides Extreme Speed, we see Jet Punch, Palafin's buff version of Aqua Jet. With it being on such a strong Pokemon, and 50% stronger than most other priority moves, it finds itself the best actual 60 base power move. We officially move into the territory of strong attacks. At 65 base power, the rest of these moves don't get boosted by Technician. The new moves Stone Axe and Ceaseless Edge are amazing signature moves that set up Stealth Rock and Spikes respectively. They are also boosted by the Sharpness ability these Pokemon have access to. But as amazing as those moves are, the winner of this has to be Knock Off. This might be the best move in the game as it removes the target's item while doing great damage. It is also widely accessible, making it even better, as it is almost necessary to run on Pokemon who have access. Onto the 70 base power moves, they aren't as broken as the 65 base power moves, but there's still a lot of good choices. Sucker Punch is a powerful priority move that only works if the target is attacking, and I just about put Freeze Dry as the best for this base power, as its effect of hitting water type super effectively makes it very hard to switch in. Volt Switch is a great pivot move doing solid damage while allowing you to switch, but it does have a lot of counterplay. While the top move of this base power in U-Turn doesn't share that trait. The bug type has no immunities, so this move will almost always give you a free switch while doing solid damage. It is such an important move in singles, as switching is very common, and scouting switches with a pivot move is a great way to get an upper hand. Choice Pokemon love this move, as they mitigate the downside of being locked into a single move. At 75 base power, we have some really great draining moves like Giga Drain and Drain Punch. Spirit Break and Rock Slide would also be contenders for best. That is if they weren't all outshined by the stupidly strong Wicked Blow. This move was nerfed down to 75 base power from 80, allowing it to take the throne here. The trait of always landing a critical hit, combined with being a contact move, allowing it to go through Protect with Unseen Fist, place it in a high tier of all moves. 80 base power is next, which might have the best group of moves to choose from out of all base powers. When I'm not even considering great moves like Body Press, Discharge, and Fiery Dance to name a few, you know there's steep competition. The top contenders consisted of great moves like Oblivion Wing, Dire Claw, Torch Song, and Extreme Speed. These are all really great moves Pokemon would run if they had access, but I have to give it to the move I often say is the best move in the game. This is the move Scald. I'm a big hater of this move, as I feel it's too strong of a tool, having solid power, and a crazy 30% burn chance for a water type move, but it is no doubt one of, if not the most broken move that is widely accessible, and it gets a nod for the best move at 80 base power. At 85 base power, we have another set of great moves, but I don't feel I need to mention a bunch when we have Bolt Beak and Vicious Rend. These moves double in power if the user moves first or the target switches, making them extremely strong. I talk about them in my video about the best signature moves of each type if you want to hear more about why they're such strong moves. I'll go with Vicious Rend for the top move though, since it doesn't have a whole type that's immune to it. 90 base power I feel is the threshold of where the move feels really strong, even as a non-stab option. It would be a shame not to mention Thunderbolt and Ice Beam, as they have been longtime staple moves. First impression is the strongest priority in the game at 90 base power, but it is limited by only being usable on the first turn you can attack and its bug typing. The best moves of this power are probably the great signature moves we have. Triple Arrows and its free effects make it a sweet move, along with Spectral Feast's ability to steal stat boosts. For the top choice though, I'm gonna go with Thousand Arrows. Being able to hit Pokemon who are flying type or levitating while also making them vulnerable to ground moves is so good. Zygarde wouldn't be nearly as good if it wasn't for this amazing move boosting it up. 95 base power has a lot less options for moves to choose from with only 6. Out of these 6, I have 2 that I have trouble deciding on. First we have Moonblast. If we are just considering singles, I would go with this no doubt. Great power, lots of PP, and a great 30% chance to drop special attack. Just an all-around amazing move for fairies. Then we have Mighty Cleave, which has a very useful effect of hitting through protection. This is important in doubles where protection is used far more often. I give the edge to Mighty Cleave in doubles, but I think Moonblast is that much better in singles considering the PP, distribution, and secondary effect, so I'll say slight edge to Moonblast. 100 base power and we are officially in the triple digits. Real strong moves. Factors like accuracy and secondary effects are going to be even more important now. The first great move that comes to mind is Earthquake, but I know there are a lot of great signature moves that have to beat it. Diamond Storm is pretty great, with its only downside being low PP and 95% accuracy, but the high chance to boost defense by 2 stages is worth the slight risk. Malignant Chain is a great new move synergizing with Petrarunt's ability very well. I'm going to give the top spot to Sacred Fire though, which is like a combination of those two moves in a way. It has a 95% accuracy, a 50% chance to activate a secondary effect, which is burning their target. This in turn makes you bulkier on the defensive side. It's a very hard move to switch into, especially physical attackers, and is only helped being on such a great offensive typing. 110 base power moves start to have some accuracy problems. We have situationally great moves like Hurricane, Blizzard, and Thunder, which all have great secondary effects while never missing in certain weathers. But the water type yet again brings us a couple solid moves. First we have Origin Pulse, which is still not the most accurate, but hits both opponents in doubles and is usually boosted by rain. I just like the move Steam Eruption better though. If I say Scald is the best widely accessible move in the game, I can't just ignore Buff Scald. It has 95% accuracy, which means it will miss a lot less than Origin Pulse, and the 30% burn chance makes switching into this move that much harder. Jumping to 120, the theme of this base power is lowering your own stats or taking recoil. I asked for your input on a poll, and your votes and comments really helped me make the decision. Make sure to subscribe by the way so you can participate in these polls and be a part of the decision making process. While moves like Headlong Rush, Dragon Ascent, and Armor Cannon are elite moves that lower stats, and moves like Flare Blitz, Brave Bird, and Volt Tackle are really strong, they do deal recoil damage. Other moves like Make It Rain, Glaive Rush, and Seed Flare are awesome, but do have their own drawbacks. The best moves were clear to be Glacial Lance and Astral Barrage. While my initial thoughts were these moves low PP and distribution could put other moves in contention, the fact of the matter is, their ability to hit with no drawbacks and also be great spread moves with great offensive types pushes them above the more accessible moves. Close Combat did receive the most votes however, and I do agree the accessibility of this move and its great offensive typing for a coverage move would have it in the top position if it weren't for these other moves. If you want me to choose just one for best though, I'll choose Glacial Lance. But what do you think the best 120 base power move is? At 125 base power, we see Vine Whip's cool big brother Solar Blade. It gets the nod as the only move at this base power, taking some notes on how to get into a map bud video. At 130 base power, we see a lot of strong moves that lower your own stats, like Flur Cannon, Draco Meteor, Leaf Storm, and Overheat. Electro Shad is also a pretty good move in the rain. But I'm going to give the honor to the moves Bolt Strike and Blue Flare. They are essentially clones of each other, with their only drawback being low PP and 85% accuracy. They boast great offensive typings and 20% chances to inflict their respective status. I'll give the edge to Blue Flare, based on not having a whole typing immune to it, giving it more spam ability. At 140 base power, there's a mix of charge moves that pretty much suck, and then some other moves that are pretty situational. We do have two really great moves in here though, in Psycho Boost, which is like those 130 base powers that sharply lower your stats, except this move avoided the nerf, likely thanks to being a signature move. I'm going to give the top spot to Boom Burst though. It just is such a great move, even with its normal typing. Great as a stab move, and great as a coverage move on Pokemon who have it. It goes through substitutes as a sound based move, has a solid amount of PP, it just has a lot going for it. At 150 base power, we have a lot of recharge moves like Hyper Beam and its variations. My top moves of this base power though, are the moves with power based on your HP. Dragon Energy, Water Spout, and Eruption. There's also Head Smash, which became a lot better with more Rock Head Pokemon learning it. My top two have to go to Dragon Energy and Eruption though. Dragon Energy is really good on Regidrago, being powered up by Dragon's Maw, but it does have an entire type immune to it, which helps to balance it. But I think Eruption will be my number one, as I think more Pokemon have a use for it, and you'll find very few Pokemon that can just come in and take it, or be immune. At 160 base power, we have two moves that are signature Hyper Beam clones, which aren't really that great competitively. And then we have the newer move, Gigaton Hammer, which saved me from having to put Prismatic Laser on this list. It's easily the best out of the three, with the downside being you can't use it twice in a row, but you'll still see it on every Tinkaton. Jumping to 180 base power, we get to the moves that stand alone. Obviously, I'm not counting Z moves or Max moves or anything of that sort here. We have V-Create as the only option here, but it's a really good option to have, so no complaints here. At 200 base power, we have Self-Destruct. The second highest base power move, and the poor man's version of the last move on this list. Ending with another boom, at 250 base power, Explosion caps off this ranking. It has the highest base power of all moves, and stands alone in that regard. There are certainly a lot of fluctuations with base power, so this list had to be done this way for me to keep my sanity. Don't forget to drop a comment on what you think the best moves of each base power are. If you enjoyed the video, become a bud and hit that sub, and make sure to check out this video next. See you later, buds.